think I'm kind of short on 3-star resources, to be honest. But I have enough where I can refine today, and I won't have to refine until tomorrow morning. So if you're wondering about the refinery, I should put this in my ebook about this game. My game guide, remember those? I used to have a whole set of those. I was given from when I worked at Nintendo. I don't have them in my immediate possession right now. Technically, I was the last owner, so I don't know where they are. I hope they're still around. They were so expensive, like the MSRP price was on the back. So, now these two systems on the left side, for me, seem to be safer, because on the right side, there's literally people there that just wait for you to get offline. And then they will gank your ship, is what I say. So it's kind of a weird, like, guessing game with how this game is. Now, I've saved up 612,000 Tritanium, which sounds like a lot. You're like, wow, that's... But if you think about a ship, let's say that's 200 feet long, right? And now the Enterprise is listed over 2,000 feet long. For some estimates, you know, if 612,000 kilograms, let's say that K stands for kilograms, you know, that's not that much material, to be honest, for a ship that big. So, well, that sounds like a lot, right? It sounds like 300 tons of stuff. But if you're gonna upgrade, like, the entire hull, all the armor, all the flooring, all the walls, all the mechanical parts. Then it's not going to be adequate. So. Now, that says mission complete. I thought that was going to take me to the Valkas. Now, I was just at the screen there. So, I wonder if I can get back to that screen. Until you offer bottom buy-in. Yeah, I got the Franklin. I haven't built that ship yet. Now, on this account, I should build the Franklin. Now, if you're wondering if you can trade parts to another user, you can't yet in this game. But I'm thinking for the next... They could do it in the next update. That's possible, but most likely it'll be in the next version of this game, which will have a different engine and all sorts of stuff. It might be a whole different company that makes it too. Like a second... game studio that'll do it. So now we're starting that one, so I don't have to worry about. See, I can't access. Isn't that where the ship construction money doesn't allow me to go to that ship? Okay. Obviously, I'm not most familiar with this. this user interface is what I want to call it. Now that noise sounds kind of statically, so it's weird. Other videos sound really clear, but I guess because the volume on it is not right. So we're going to recall this ship here, and I'm going to swap it into the Valkas. So when I was looking at different ships, and there's already videos, kind of short videos on YouTube about the ships. You don't see a chart or sometimes the details on how much it costs to build. And then sometimes I go through the upgrades. Only Fortis seems to show the upgrades, but he does it so fast, I can't pause it fast enough. So, at the point that's the one I wanted to see, so I could plan ahead. played games for a while, and it's always good to plan ahead. Makes your experience happier. Now that's gonna take almost 6 minutes. So we're gonna go to the refinery. This is like everything else and not the Valkas at the beginning. I'm sorry. If you wanna skip to the minute mark, I will try to put that in the video description. And I wish I could shove it into the title, but a lot of YouTube users don't know that there's a 100-character limit, so we can't put more than 100 characters. Now maybe the premium accounts or guys like Jimmy Kimmel can put more on their title, but I don't really know. My account, I can only do 100 characters, so even though my account's been open since 2003, so that's when I remember opening my first YouTube account, which was connected to Google. So I didn't actually explicitly sign up for YouTube. So now this two-star stuff might be useful for a second tower which I could build after this Franklin. This will be done by tomorrow morning. So that's kind of useful if you're gonna do hostile missions. You can put two talas and don't have to worry about, because if you're wondering how much a tala costs to repair, it's gonna be about a third versus a cura. And mine's almost level tier 4. It's like level 15. You can't get past that unless you tier up. So now if you're wondering if you should use the 3 chests all the time, can, but it's so hard to get 50,000 more with the setup I have right now. I don't have my miners aren't fast enough to collect that much. So I mean, they are technically, if nobody disturbed them and they were mining non-stop, like if you did the theoretical math, right? But in reality, it's not going to be easy to get more than average, like let's say 10,000 ore in a day, even if you're on and off your accounts. So now if you have the help of people who can guard your ship and counter pirators or attackers before they enter the space near your ship, then you got a chance. But that system's a little tricky. So I used to be, I think in PvP, like in Command and Conquer, you can attack anything in the game, even places where, like if you press Control, I remember on the computer, you could attack any position, even there's nothing there. Just like shoot at the ground. But like in this game, that button isn't readily available. So if you make a zone around you, and you just put it in the chat, like we're gonna shoot anybody who gets near my miner that is a attack vessel. I think they'll listen. And if you want to enter in mine with your battleship, please ask. Yeah, I mean something like that. And if you guard it, then you'll be able to mine. But that's the way it's set up now. It's a pretty elaborate system. So most people just end up leveling. And see, your ship is sent directly back home, and protected cargo goes into your base. And once it's in your base, it can't get out. Like the outside of the three materials that you see on the top corner. Parts and raw ore and stuff, and even refined ore, it stays there. So it is 100% safe. I have never lost any of that stuff in the items here, but I have lost a little bit. Now compared to all I've spent, a little bit of this stuff here at the top here. So total, I've used a lot more. I'd like to see a total of what I've used so far. I think that would surprise and shock me. So there's still 1 minute left here. This is almost at full unprotected. I'll recall this. You can see there's no other ship here. I'm the only node here, and there might be one floating. These red ones are not other people ships. They're actually, but these bases are actually other people's bases. I think I got a 4-hour chess, so 29 seconds left on the clock. We have not had time to open up both chesses, and we might go over that 29 seconds, but that's okay. It's worth it. For that Borg mission, it says level recommended 25. I don't know. You might be able to get away with a 23 or 24, but... I don't even know how to start that mission. I tried to look it up a few times. I asked in chat. There's some videos about it, but I haven't watched any. So I'm not a big fan of the Borg to begin with. And I don't think it's gonna give me like, I don't really want a Borg ship. I already got like 10 ships I try to manage already, so I don't need a Borg ship. I don't even know what it looks like. There's no advertisement for that. But there's some Borg crew members that help, like this guy here. Right now, we actually can... I guess somehow we got some special. So if there's a special here, you want to use it while you have it. Like, you don't want to risk 1 of 10. Remember there was 7 of 9? And that was like their designation. I don't know why it's all white. That's weird. So you have enough for 1... Now these have different abilities, but they level up the same, so the cost of XP is about the same for each level as your regular recruits. Alright, so we got shards. Now I used to think you just open up and you got the guy right away, but this game doesn't go that fast. It's not like Final Fantasy VII with the player cards or Pokemon. There's some other characters there. So you have to collect enough shards, and it's pretty much auto-generated. So it's on a tier schedule, is what I would explain. Now you can ask your software professor what that means, but it's better to ask the guy who actually sells real software and understands it at least, right? Professor will provide you some basic definitions or a half story or a half joke for you. But if he's never sold at least $1,000 of software in his life, I don't know if I could trust him. Now, if he's a software salesman only, that's something different, but you know. That goes in a whole set of stories I don't want to talk to about. I don't want to talk about right now. So I had a chance to get him. I don't know if I got him. Like usually the new recruit opens up. I think I already viewed him. He doesn't have anything too special. Like his abilities would help, but it's not gonna save you or make you like a level stronger. So those one ship level stronger is still more useful than just putting a premium recruit. So on your ship, just one premium recruit. Nevada. Man, can you go to the table and get ice for me? I'm gonna leave that. I'm a yawner about you now. No. Okay. So if you're wondering how you switch ships, you click on the ship icon on the docks, then you press on the manage button, and then once you go to manage, you press on this button, and dry dock it says swap ship, and And now you can pick the bot class. Look at those numbers. That's pretty impressive. It's already 55,000. I don't have to do anything. It says level 1. Wow. So this ship I've seen other players have. They're up to 100,000 already. Of course, they're ahead of me. They're either premium or they played months ahead. Like Rev has been there, I think, since 2018. I was never on this. I didn't even know this game existed. 2018, to be honest. You can see the Tritanum cost here. So each one, this is not a total for like everything here, but each one of these costs this amount. So you can see it's like 103 star, and that's why I saved. See, I'm glad I didn't spend. So I couldn't spend it, to be honest, much on the other ships. So this is really worth it. So I see why people skip the next ship, and Fortis recommends it too. Because some people do it. I'm like, you know, I think everybody will do it. Eventually. And somebody who started at the beginning of the game, had a lot of free time, or put a lot of time in their account, they can do all three ships, right? So you can see the amount of Tritanium is going to go down real fast here. The cargo bay is the cheapest. There's only two materials here, or three resources here. Two 3-star materials is what I was about to say. But like the phaser beam, I prefer. But I get the warp engine because that's cheap and that helps me get to systems that are higher. Now the phaser beam, so it's 7% for that. Now this is 8% defense. This is the shield though. Okay, we're definitely going to go with the shield. So it's good to compare the numbers. It's not all the same. Some are like the lowest teen level ships you get, the first three ships. There's not a big difference here, even at the last tier. But once you get the 20s, this is like a critical decision. Once you do it, it's so hard to undo. You would have to ask Scoppy support, who can undo the last action on my account? Now, I know there's somebody who can. Now 126k left. Now there's three sets of weapons here. Sometimes it's like two different kinds, like torpedoes. But these are all phaser beams. So there is a ship that's nothing but phaser beams. That is really cool. They're all about the same. We're gonna make some screenshots here. Now I'm gonna put this in a PowerPoint. I might do this off camera here. We're gonna go off camera.